I'm here with Mr. Richard DeVaughn. How are you doing today, sir?
Doing well, thank you.
Glad to be here.
Great. So you are the founder of Jaro?
Yes, of Jaro, yes.
Jaro. Okay, so tell me a little bit about that. What's your platform, and explain everything to me and for the people at home.
Okay. Well, Jaro is a streaming platform that our focus is on providing diverse types of content. And our content really consists of editorial, podcasting, art, music, and books, and in movies, obviously. So we do all of that. And our focus is on emerging, particularly emerging content, indie content, with content that is of interest to African American audiences, right? So that's what we do, right? We've been in business for about 3 years. We are on a variety of different types of platforms. We have our own internet TV. We're on Roku, right? And we're here, you know, as part of the Peachtree Village International Film Festival, sponsoring the short film competition, where we're featuring 19 really great short films.
Okay. So tell me, what is one of your biggest challenges as being a new streaming platform?
Well, the number one challenge is obviously audience building. And a parallel challenge, which I'll say is number one also, is content acquisition, you know, getting the kinds of content. And where we're differentiating ourselves from the others is the fact that we're focused on emerging, but we're also creating a community of content providers with content that's, you know, of interest to an audience that wants to see it. You know, so we want to connect the audience and the content together.
Got it.
You know, so that's what we're doing.
Okay. So if there's anyone that's interested in maybe submitting any type of feature film or any sort of content for your platform, how would they do so?
They can go directly to our website, watchjaro.com. Scroll down to the bottom. It says submit, you know, and then the instructions are there. It's very, very easy, you know.
Gotta love an easy platform. Okay, so where do you see streaming going in the next probably 5 to 10 years, and how do you think that's going to affect content providers?
Well, what's going on with streaming today is you've seen a lot of different companies like BT. You see companies like Disney. You see Apple. You see a variety of large concerns, QB, that are very specialized. So you're going to see streaming to the point where you're going to, different companies are entering the space for different reasons. Mm. You know, for example, Apple is into it because, in my view, you know, they have a huge installed audience and they sell a lot of hardware.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
And so for them, it's a no-brainer.
Right.
Right? How to leverage that. For Disney, on the other hand, you know, Disney's a huge media conglomerate. They have a tremendous amount of content. It's just another way for them to market their content. Plus, they want to stay in the game,
right?
Right? You know, and other, like, for example, more like broadband companies, like cable companies that are moving into the streaming space, they do it for defensive purposes. They have to be there, right? They have a large installed base, and they have to be there. Now, the impression that content providers typically have is that, oh, these are new opportunities. They really aren't. In general, they're not. Mm-hmm. In some cases, there may be some additional content. But remember, you still have a limited amount of content providers who are, what I'll say, prime for these different platforms. You know, Disney's going to have their content. They'll maybe provide some additional opportunities for the Tyler Perrys or the Ava DuVernays and those type of platforms, those type of people. But the independents are going to be in line waiting. So our platform provides that opportunity to compete in a more in a space that's a little more less competitive, I'll say, and more targeted towards the audience they want to reach, and has a higher opportunity for monetization for them. So there'll be some players. So in the future, as the market continues to fragment for different reasons, it will then take the normal course of consolidating. Right? They'll consolidate back into a few big players, and then everyone else will be kind of on the outside looking in, and content will be controlled as it always has been controlled, and there won't be that much of an avenue for independents to really blow up.
Right.
they have to get real lucky.
Right.
So we want to provide that opportunity that's of something that's our own, create that community that we can allow at least a select group of those content providers to have a place to that they can call their own and blow up. So that's
well, I appreciate you taking time to interview with us today, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your weekend at the Peachtree Village International Film Festival.
Well, thank you for doing it for me. Thank